God, when are rappers gonna learn that we do not want albums this fucking long? Juice WRLD is here! He's back with his second studio album, Death Race for Love. Before I even get into the review, I just want to say that I really love this album cover. Probably because I'm a big fan of PlayStation, and it's designed after not only a PS1 cover, but specifically the cover of Twisted Metal 4. And even though I never really played the Twisted Metal series, I think it's awesome that he's basically referencing video games on his cover, because I'm a gamer, so nice. But I honestly was a little bit skeptical going into this album, and not because I don't like Juice WRLD, because in the lead up to this album I did listen to his debut record Goodbye and Good Riddance. I hadn't listened to it when it came out, so I listened to it recently, and I actually liked it quite a bit. It wasn't the most amazing thing that I had heard, and it was spotty at points, but there were some songs that I really liked on it. I liked Lucid Dreams, the lead single. I liked All Girls Are the Same, Wasted, Lean With Me, stuff like that. They were really solid tracks. Lucid Dreams, by the way, was his biggest song. A lot of you guys have heard it. It peaked at number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100 and number 12 on the year-end Hot 100. So admittedly, I was excited at first to listen to this album because Juice has a good ear for melody, and I've heard people even call him the king of emo rap. And having enjoyed his first album a bit, I was excited to see what he would do. Then the revelation came forward that this album was going to be an hour and 12 minutes long, spread across 22 tracks. I've talked about this before, so I'm not going to spend a whole long time ranting about it because my first review on this channel, I talked about this. Why do rappers think that we still want 20 plus song albums? I mean, I get it, they're trying to game the streams. And while I'm a little more excited to hear Juice WRLD put out 22 songs than I would be for like Future or Migos, that doesn't mean I'm any more excited about an hour long album. Because when you're making an album that's an hour long, you either need to be conceptual, you need to be telling a story, or you need to have bangers from top to bottom without much filler. Juice WRLD, while I like some of his music and I did enjoy his first record, it was spotty, and I am worried about how he could handle 22 tracks. Not only that, but there's not really many features on this thing. There's 3 features, and one of them is on an interlude, so it's not like it's gonna be anything other than Juice throughout this thing. But okay, I was excited to listen to it because I did like his first album, and I'm at least hoping that this album gives me a few new fun tracks to enjoy. So I'm gonna give it a chance. I'm gonna hope for the best. Please, Juice WRLD, don't let me down. I've been hearing some mixed things early on. I am like a day late to listen to this, but that's because I was editing the 2 Chainz reaction. I've heard some people say it's actually pretty good, but a lot of people have been saying that it's bogged down by its length, so I guess we'll see as we listen to the album. Let's just get into it. Track number 1 is called Empty. Say what you want about Juice WRLD, but he can come through with some really catchy melodies. Admittedly, I think that's a good start to the album. I've said this before, even though I only just really started listening to Juice WRLD recently. If nothing else, he's really good at coming through with some really catchy vocal melodies, and right there, he definitely does. His vocals are nice, the song has a really emotional vibe to it. It does feel legitimately sad when he says he feels so goddamn empty. It's a good track to vibe to, I definitely really dig it. That said, does it make me any more excited to listen to 21 more versions of it? Probably not, but hopefully some of the other ones are as catchy as that. By the way, if I keep my sum ups a bit short, sorry, it's just that this album is as long as it is, and I don't want this video to be as long as it is. Track number 2 is called Maze. I I wasn't as crazy about that one. I feel like the dark instrumentals on it weren't quite as captivating to me. The vocal melodies, again, super catchy. I think that Juice sounds great on it. I kind of get some weird throwbacks to listening to, like, Goo Goo Dolls or something like that while listening to this, which is kind of cool, and he sounds good on it. Again, I'm just not crazy about the production. It's not quite as interesting here, and I don't really find it all that memorable. Maybe it'll grow on me. Maybe I just have to listen to it a few more times. Maybe the kind of off-kilter sound to it will eventually grow on me, but for now, not really all that crazy about it. Track number 3 is called HeMotions. Another life, another day, another chance to make it great. I'm really to the money all the time, so I can never relate. Me and my bitch, even though she drive me crazy, she still make my day. Going through motions, muddy emotions, back on my bullshit, double emotion. Under that bitch, an ocean. If I can't make her smile, I'm gonna be acting wild. She got a new man, I'm gonna pull up on him and shoot him down. My bullshit, double emotion. Meh. All I can say about that is meh. I'm not gonna lie, I think that was one of Juice WRLD's most boring hooks yet. I feel like it didn't really play to his vocal abilities all that well. The instrumental was very bog standard, and I feel like I didn't really get a whole lot out of it. I thought that track was just boring, and now I'm scared because I was enjoying how this was starting and I was hoping this could buck the long album trend, but now I'm a little bit worried. I don't think the track was absolutely terrible, but by Juice WRLD's standards, I know that he could do way better than that. Track number 4 is called Demons. It's an interlude, and it features Brent Faiyaz. I hope I said that right. Damn, now I wish that wasn't an interlude. Brent Faiyaz, if I said his name right, he sounded really, really good on that track. It's a light, minimal track, and it's very nice. I just wish there was more to it. I wish it wasn't just an interlude. I wish that Brent had a little more time to really show us his vocal chops, because they're there. And I think it sounds great. I just wish there was more to it. Track number 5 is called Fast. I actually like that line, because I've been saying stuff like that, just because you're rich doesn't mean you're happy. I like that one line where he was talking about how it's okay that he's sad because he's rich, psych, he's actually not happy now. Because I've talked about that with a lot of different people, how just because you're rich that doesn't mean you're happy and stuff like that. So I like that line, and I kind of felt the song growing on me at least a little as it went on. I had it as one of my least favorites at first, but then it started to grow a little bit. I still think it is pretty boring. I don't really think the instrumental on that is all that captivating. I think Juice's melodies on it are kind of fun, not his best. I don't think his vocals are all that captivating on the song either. But, I mean, I guess it could grow on me if I give it a few more listens. Track number 6 is called Hear Me Calling. I believe this was one of the singles from the album, so let's hear how it is because I didn't get to listen to the singles. This is kind of weird hearing Juice WRLD do a dancehall song. That one took some getting used to be honest. I think it was a little weird hearing Juice WRLD jump onto what is essentially a dancehall song, but you know, I think it sounds pretty nice. The beat took a little while to get used to, but again, Juice's vocal melodies are catchy. I don't think it's one of the best songs that he's ever done, but I do like it. I think it's catchy, it's nice, mellow, and I could see myself coming back to it. Track number 7 is called Big. My. I liked where it was going at first, but now I'm not a big fan of it. Well. Man, I want to be able to enjoy this a bit more, but I don't. Oh my god. Lord. I liked where that was going at first, but then it just kind of got killed by all the distortion and stuff like that. And again, Juice's vocal melodies there, I would say, weren't quite as catchy as they usually are. They just sounded very bog standard and not really all that fun, to be completely honest with you. I wanted to enjoy it. At the beginning, I was like, I like the direction that this is going in. But then it just fell off really quick. It makes me so sad because I wanted to love this album, but so far, this is not the best start that it could be off to. Track number 8 is called Robbery, and I believe this was the lead-off single, so I'm excited to listen to this because I've heard some pretty good things about it. I definitely see why people like that track. I think it sounds very emotional. The instrumentals are very sad and the pianos are very light on it. And Juice's vocals are a lot more emotional and more vulnerable there. I think that that is a really, really strong track. It might even be one of his best. So I could definitely see why people are praising it so much. It sounds pretty good. Track number 9 is called Flaws and Sins. Say It Ain't So by Weezer. Sounds like he's doing a Swae Lee impression. You know, they say that emo rap is supposed to make you sad. Well, now I'm certainly sad because I wish that this was better. I don't know, I just feel like that song sounded phoned in. It didn't really feel like it was all that captivating or exciting or doing anything differently than any other Juice WRLD or emo rap track that I've heard in my life. The melodies weren't that catchy, his vocals weren't all that great. Again, like I said, there was a part where it sounded like he was doing a Swae Lee impression. It just feels phoned in. Like, it's thrown on there as filler. Or just to pad out the length of the album. It's a shame. I wanted to really love this thing, but right now I can't. Track number 10 is called Feeling. So disappointed already. Again, it just unfortunately feels phoned in. Like, it doesn't feel like the instrumentals are all that captivating. It doesn't feel like the instrumentals are doing anything differently that you haven't heard before, or anything all that exciting or sticky for that matter. And I've mentioned throughout this review that Juice WRLD is really good when it comes to melodies. He's really good at just making catchy, earwormy melodies. Here? No. These things are just going in one ear and then out the other for me. It's a shame. I don't want to hate this, because I don't want to dislike this album because I was excited for Juice WRLD, but... He's not giving me much to work with here. Track number 11 is called Syphilis, for some bizarre reason.
Disrespect, then I'm gonna take your breath.
The only thing I could see that really being, if it ends up being remembered outside of this album, is that song that at concerts people end up moshing to. Otherwise, again, I'm not crazy about the super distorted instrumentals on it. And Juice's performance, while occasionally charismatic, to me it just kind of feels like he's biting the style of like XXXTentacion or something like that. Like, I hear that song and it kind of reminds me of that Floor 555 song from XXXTentacion's album Question Mark. Probably just because, like, it reminds me of the fuck boy don't test me part of the song. I don't know, I just hear that and I'm like, wow, it almost sounds like he's just biting X's flow. It doesn't seem like he's really trying to bring much different to the table. He's just trying to be X. It's definitely not for me, unfortunately. Track number 12 is called Who Shot Cupid. I like these guitars. And then the trap drums came in. Oh. It's a shame because, again, I was really liking how that started with the light guitars, but then the trap drums kicked in and then that almost killed the song immediately for me. Now, luckily, I don't think it's one of the worst on the album because, at the very least, there are some moments where Juice has some fun vocally and sounds kind of nice, but I feel like, again, the trap drums didn't really aid the production that much and the hook wasn't really all that catchy either. Just felt like there was so much going on that there wasn't really one aspect of it that really hooked me in. I don't know. I wasn't digging that one either. I'm so disappointed so far. Track number 13 is called Ring Ring featuring Clever. I don't know who Clever is, but this album needs a feature because we need a little bit more flavor. I don't know who Clever is, but his vocals were fire right there. Okay, now I like that one. Yeah, that was actually really good. I like the guitars, and I feel like Juice's vocals there and the filters on them actually fit against the kind of rock vibe to it. And also, Clever, his vocals, I've never really heard of him, but his vocals were so great. I almost feel like he sounds like a rock musician. He sounds like he would do great up against any rock-styled song. Definitely one of the better tracks on this thing so far. I really dig it. Track number 14 is called Desire. And we're back into rather generic territory. Well, I mean, his vocals still sound nice at least, I'll give him that. Really, that's all the song has going for it in my opinion. I feel like vocally, he still sounds like he's doing some really solid things and he sounds very emotional throughout the song. But otherwise, I feel like there's nothing about it that makes it really special for me. There's nothing about the song that really catches me or hooks me into it. It just feels like very standard trap stuff. And it's a shame because that's kind of how a lot of this album has felt and I was hoping it would be a little more unique and interesting, but alas, here we are. I guess you can't always get what you want. Track number 15 is called Out My Way. I don't know.
I don't know what to say anymore.
Did he just say that the sad songs are a facade? Alright, so first and foremost, again, I felt like that song wasn't really that special to me. It just kind of read as being like any other song that I've heard. The trap instrumentals were kind of boring. Even if they were trying to be more energetic, it just sounded very standard. Juice's flows were kind of catchy, but still a little bit boring, and it's not like he was really playing to his great vocal chops. And this is one of the big problems that I have with this song. One of the lyrics he says, as I have it here, is, "They think I'm a bitch because they heard the sad songs, that's a facade." I mean, it's not like he really helped become a figurehead of a new movement of sad rap music, and now suddenly is saying that it's a facade that he kind of jumped on. I mean, granted, I could be reading too far into it, but I feel like given how big he is in the scene of sad rap and emo rap, to admit that making sad songs is a facade almost seems like the wrong thing to do. I mean, you got really big by making those kind of songs, and your biggest song is a sad rap song, but now we're all supposed to believe that it's fake? What do we make of it then? I feel like that's a weird contradiction to be one of the biggest people in a scene of sad rap music and then saying that being sad is a facade. I could be reading too far into it, but I just don't really agree with that lyric, to be completely honest. I think it's really weird and contradictory. Track number 16 is called The Bee's Knees, and it's 5.5 minutes. I am terrified. I have to listen to 5.5 minutes of this. That song was saved by the beat switch. I felt like if the beat switch was the entire song, it would have been one of my favorites because I really liked the way it sounded. I liked his vocals. The song itself had a light vibe to it and it was kind of just airy and carefree. But the first part was just really painfully boring and dull, and that's a shame because I really liked the second part. I liked how the beat switched. I just wish that was the whole song, to be honest. Track number 17 is called On God featuring Young Thug, who has been on every album that I've reviewed, it feels like, at this point. I mean, hey, this album needs some more flavor, so hopefully Young Thug can help out. Sorry that I got up and had to move around, but this album is honestly boring me to the point where I really need a move. It's a shame. I thought Young Thug was actually gonna bring some flavor to that track and he was gonna bring some character, but I feel like that was not one of his best feature verses or feature performances. Again, it just feels like phoned-in emo rap at this point. It's not really doing anything different. It's not really doing anything that grabs me or anything like that. This is the first time where I've been reviewing an album and I had to actually get up away from my computer to go move or sit elsewhere or something because this thing is boring me. And I don't want to say that. Before people just start labeling me as a hater, I wanted to enjoy this album, but it's so long and so dull and phoned in and boring at this point that I just can't. I'm sorry. Track number 18 is called 10 Feet. Been 3 weeks, I still haven't met my bills. Been raw dogging bitches ever since I went platinum. I feel
like hell full of bad bitches. Wonder if it's room in heaven for savages. My life's a canvas, I'm painting in blood like a cannibal. Rip off his head and I salvage.
Okay, so this album still does have a little bit of room for surprise. I wasn't expecting that, but I actually really enjoyed it. I liked how bouncy the beat was, and it almost felt like I was transported back in time a little bit. Like, that didn't feel like something recent. It felt like something a little bit older. And Juice WRLD's technicality and flow was actually pretty catchy on it. I didn't expect that he'd have technicality like that, and he sounds really good. So yeah, at least I like that track. There are definitely some highlights on this thing, I'll give it that. It's just that they're way too few and far between. Track number 19 is called Won't Let Go. See, now it's a shame because I really liked Juice's vocals on that track. They sounded very emotional and just really awesome. But I feel like I'm just so burnt out from listening to so many songs that sound so similar to each other. Wow, try saying that 5 times fast. That I just can't really get into the song. And that's a shame. I want to. I really do. But I can't because it just sounds like everything else on the album. With a few exceptions, but still. I want to point out, by the way, that saying that took quite a few takes because I'm really tired right now. See what happens when these albums come out and I don't like them? This is why I don't want to not like them. Wow, I don't know if that makes any sense, but you know what I mean. I don't want to dislike them because then I get tired and don't know what I'm saying anymore. Let's just finish this album. Track number 20 is called She's the One. This is so sad to me. Juice WRLD. I trusted you. I trusted you. I'm sorry, that's a little too dramatic, but oh man. I feel like I'm so burnt out by listening to this album, and I still have 2 songs to go on it. It's a shame, because I want to love it, but that song just sounded like every other song on here. Juice's vocal melodies were not all that catchy. It was just boring. Let's just try to finish the album out. I'm repeating myself at this point, because I'm really tired. Track number 21 is called Rider. Alright, I like this song at least. I suffer from excessive road rage. Take my life and crash into this hole. Okay, at least I like that track. I liked the guitars on it, the rock influences there, and it sounds good. Juice's vocal melodies are catchy, and his vocals do sound good on it. So yeah, there at least is some room for some decent tracks on here. It's just that to get to those decent tracks, you're gonna have to get through a lot of really rough ones. But at least I'm finally at the end now. I can't believe it. It feels like it's been so long. Track number 22, the closer to the album, is called Make Believe. Ironic, by the way, that it's track number 22 and it's 2 minutes and 22 seconds. I'm calling conspiracy. I figured she was gonna bring my heart regardless. So I took her out and dropped her in the garbage. Stupid bitch to turn herself into a target. Not gonna happen if I can't have you, no one cares. If you leave, I'm not brave. So you have who's not brave, brave. Very possessive. You I liked how the production actually felt kind of different on that one, and his vocals were good too, but there was, again, just something about it that doesn't totally stick with me. Maybe it's just that the chorus isn't that catchy. Maybe some of the lyrics just feel a little bit possessive to me. I don't know. That one I wasn't really all that crazy about, unfortunately. Overall, though, I'm going to try to keep my wrap-up short because this camera is just about to hit an hour and 30 minutes, and it's also on one bar of battery, so I just want to get done with this video. I'm sorry, I didn't love this thing. I wanted to love it. I really, really did because I enjoyed his first record, but what I'm about to say about it now is probably what you're going to be hearing from a number of other people. It's just too long. It's too long, it's too unwieldy, and I feel like he easily could have chopped it down to about 12 or 13 tracks. And that's unfortunate. It's just more of an example of the business model of rap as opposed to actually making good rap. It's unfortunate that now that Juice had a breakout album last year, he's unfortunately kind of falling into the business model. Said business model being put out more instead of putting out better. We saw it last year with like Lil Yachty, who put out two albums that weren't really that great, at least in my opinion. I felt like Lil Boat 2 and Nothing to Prove were not great, but unfortunately it spoke to the business model of put out enough so that his name stays out there as opposed to putting out quality music. And unfortunately that's what Juice WRLD is falling into, because not only do we not need a 22 track album from him, but his first record isn't even a full year old yet. Did we need something this long this quick? Especially also because he collabed with Future on that World on Drugs album, which I don't know if it was that great, I didn't listen to it. But the point is, Juice WRLD has kept his name out there. Did we need a 22 track album this quickly? And even then, this could have been forgiven if it was a 22 track album that was really, really rock solid, but unfortunately, it's just filler the album. This is just what tends to happen when people put out these long albums. They're just too much filler, and that's just what happens here. A lot of the tracks are just not quite exciting, they are not as captivating, they don't rank up with some of his best songs. Some of them might, like Robbery was really good, but otherwise I feel like most of the album is just really dull and monotonous, and it's gonna take a lot of patience to get through it. I guess if you're a hardcore Juice WRLD fan, you'll probably like it. I've seen some people say that the album's actually pretty good, but me personally, I'm just really not digging it that much. My favorite tracks on here were Empty, Hear Me Calling, Robbery, Ring Ring, 10 Feet, and Rider. My least favorites on here were HeMotions, Big, Flaws and Sins, Syphilis, Out My Way, On God, and She's the One. Overall, I don't want to give it this rating, but this is just how I feel. Juice WRLD's Death Race for Love is gonna get an awful from me. I'm sorry, I don't want to give it an awful. I wanted to really like this thing and find something in it that others didn't, but it's just way too long and way too dull. I know Juice does have a distinct sound, and I do like that sound, but I just wish that he would make it a little more concise and not so long next time around. But that's just my opinion on the album. What did you guys think of it? Were you able to find something in it that I didn't? Did you agree? Did you think it was too long? Was the length not so much a problem for you? Were you able to find it so compelling that the length didn't matter? You could sound off in the comment section. Let's keep it civil and have some fun. If you guys want to hit like and subscribe, I appreciate it. If you don't have to. You know I don't beg for stuff like that. And I don't know what the next album I'm gonna be reviewing is. Depends on what comes out over the next few weeks. I might actually take a little bit of a break because I'm on spring break this week and I don't want to spend the whole time editing and filming and stuff like that, so I might take a small break. But if something comes out, I'll try to review it if it's really enticing or if it's really big, so just stay tuned. Thanks for watching. I gotta go sleep because this album is too long. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.